Hey everyone, so if you have followed my videos in a hierarchic way, you might have received a pull shark badge and galaxy brain. So I used this particular account to show you how to get the pull shark and galaxy brain. Now our next target is how to get Starstruck. So that's what we are going to discuss in this particular session today. So yep. Again, I can't show you a live demo on how to get this badge, but I can literally show you how to get this particular badge over here. All right, so let me get started with it. So first thing, understanding what is this stars thing is all about. So I've been mentioning you to star my repository here and there. Now, for example, when you create an awesome repository which can help people out there, people do come here and star the repository. And they do forecastful, right? Now, for example, let me see GitHub, Apache GitHub. So this is like Apache Airflow GitHub. So you can see this is like a GitHub platform for Apache. Now you can see Apache is like a widely recognized tool, and you can see there are around 36.2k stars over here. So that's pretty impressive over here, right? And you can see a lot of contributor, which is like 3,000 contributors, and which has been used by 11k people. So this is like how you impact the people in terms of recognition, and giving a star is such a way that showing a respect or about, okay, they are letting you to do use your resources and use your code base for your own benefit. So for example, for whoever watching this video, but don't make sure that you come and star this repository so I can explore. You know, that's a kind of showing a empathy to the other person, right? So now if you go to my profile, you will be able to see I have already received 3 cross stars, which is like I already received 512 stars throughout it. Now this stars basically counts a single repository stars, okay? This is not your overall star contribution. So it's look at your particular stars. I believe like I can come and update you on that. I do believe like this looks at your single repository stars. Oh no, sorry for that. It will look at your overall stars which you have received. For example, you can see I have received around 1k star gazes over here. Now again, that's a way that you can track all the stars which you have received so far, or you can go to your individual profiles and you can see how many stars you have received. All right, and if you want to see how much stars you have received and you want to get this, click on the edit button and copy the same URL and change it to your URL. It will give you how much stars you have achieved so far. Now, what we do is like the same way. For example, you guys can create your own repository. For example, let me go here. And I hope I taught you to create your own personal repository, right? So special README profile. So click over here. So this will give you your repository link. So you can see there is no stars, right? So now if I share this link with anyone else, for example, let me share this link over here and click on star and go back, refresh this page. I can see 1 star is already received. All right. So this is a way that you can get the stars. Maybe you can share with your peers or colleagues and let them to star your repository and tell them to come back. So now what I will be doing is like I have a small WhatsApp group of web developers. So I'll just tell them to star the repository in sake of just letting you know how this is working. So make sure that do it in a genuine way. Don't do any malpractice on getting the stars because GitHub might flag your account. All right. So this is my secondary account. I don't have to worry about it. So I'm just using it for training purpose. After this training, I will be deleting this account. All right. So I'm going to share this with my colleagues and I'll be coming back in a few minutes. All right. So I shared this particular repository with my core team. So there's like around 10 or 15 people out there. So I told them to star it. So just for the video purpose. So they did star for me. I can see there is 10 over there. Maybe I should refresh it right now. Now I can see 17 stars has been received, which is 16 is the work first criteria for the default star. All right. Now when we go back to this particular repository over here and try to refresh, I can see from 7 217 ideally. It's kind of trying to refresh. All right, so let's go to the profile and see where the star has been received. As you can see, the GitHub star achievement has been received right now. Now, as I told you, it will compare your overall star which you have received throughout. It's not just for one repository. So if you received 100 stars or maybe 120 stars in another repository, it will count 120 plus this 17 to count your overall stars to get this bronze badge. All right, so that's how the star thing working. And getting this milestone, you have to make something creative, something big. So that's the whole purpose of GitHub launching the stars. It's not just for the gamification. It's just to inspire you to build something so you can showcase in your profile. So when somebody comes and visits your profile, they know, okay, this person is somewhat good. Because getting this star of cross 3 is something, he has to be do something good and he has to have some community power to build that particular kind of milestone in your profile. Now let me know what star which you have to achieve. For example, right now we have achieved Galaxy Brain, Starstruck, and Pull Request. So let me know what badge you want to talk about in the next video, where I will show you a live demo just like how I did this. Thank you for watching this video. Maybe I will catch you in the next one. Thank you.